Hello friends, welcome to Sethi Botany classes. I am Dr. Meena Sethi. Today I'll be teaching you which indoor plants we can grow at home, how to take care of them. Once I went to market to buy an artificial plant to decorate a corner of my house, and it was really very costly. Being a botanist, I could not buy it. So I decided that I will grow certain plants inside my home, and they really look more beautiful as compared to artificial plant. And friends, they are economical also. So today I'll tell you about 10 indoor plants which we can easily grow at our place in our homes. Now, first is Aglaonema. Its botanical name is Aglaonema cleopatra. This belongs to family Aeraceae. Now this plant is very easy to grow, does not require much sunlight. And this requires water when its soil is dry, otherwise we are not going to water this plant, but this requires aeration. Now this is Calathea vittata, family Marantaceae. Very beautiful to look, it will grow very slowly. Again, we have to water it twice or thrice a week. Doesn't require much sunlight. Again, this is Calathea species, Roseopicta, belongs to family Marantaceae. A very beautiful plant, easy to grow, easy to maintain. Now this is Zamia zamioculcus, belongs to family Aeraceae. Now this plant has leaves, which are very hardy kind leaves. And it can store water for many days under its stem part, rhizome part. Now we can water this plant within a week for one day only, and this will be easily maintained because this is a very hardy plant. This can survive without water for many days and doesn't require much sunlight. Now this is arrowhead plant, Syngonium podophyllum. Belongs to family Aeraceae. Very easy to grow. And if shade is there, this will be very green in color. We have to water it properly, but this will grow at any place in our house and really increase the beauty of our places at home. Spider plant, very beautiful plant. Chlorophytum commosum, family Anthracaceae. Now this plant, we have to keep it outside in the sun. Once a week, and we will keep it in the sun for almost 3-4 hours, and make sure when you keep plant outside in the sun from the shady condition, don't keep it in the intense sunlight, because intense sunlight will give a shock reaction to the plant. So first we will keep our plant in a place outside our home which is partially shady and partially sunny. This is corn plant, Dracaena fragrans. Now, belongs to family Asparagaceae. Again, we will water it properly. Even spider plant, we have to water it properly. And we will keep it in sunlight once a week for 3-4 hours. And again, we will take care that it should not be kept in intense sunlight. Dragon tree, very beautiful to look at. This is red live plant. Botanical name is Dracaena marginata. Family Asparagaceae, easy to maintain. We can water this plant once a week, not much to maintain. Now this is Areca palm. This is the most common plant which we grow in offices, our homes, and this really give an aesthetic beauty to our corners in the home. And this is easy to grow, but we have to take care of its soil. Its soil should remain moist, it should not be dry. When its leaf tips turn brown in color, that means we are not watering it properly. We have to water the plants depending upon their requirement. We will not overwater the plant, we will not underwater the plant. If we will overwater the plant, then the roots will be rotten. And if we will underwater the plant, then water and minerals will not be transported properly, nutrients will not be transported properly inside the plant, and plant will show stunted growth. Its botanical name is Dipsis luxens, family Ericaceae. Now this is Sansevieria, snake plant, Its botanical name is Dracaena trifasciata, family Asparagaceae. Easy to maintain, easy to propagate, easy to multiply, doesn't require much water. We can give this plant water once in 15 days, and this will be easily surviving without water. Now, we are growing these indoor plants because they are good to look at in our houses. But they have certain other advantages also. Like in our houses, we use chemicals throughout the day, like paste, detergent, and floor cleaners. So our indoor air is filled with volatile vapors of chemicals like toluene, xylene, benzene, and many other pollutants. Now these pollutants will be curbed by these indoor plants, because all these indoor plants, when they do photosynthesis, they will evolve oxygen and they will absorb carbon dioxide. During that process, they will purify our indoor air by releasing more of the oxygen. Another aspect of plant is that we can interact with plant. We can see their growth, like we can see their growing buds, we can see their growing leaves, and we will enjoy that. That will increase our productivity. That will also boost positive energy in the home. This will also help in improving our concentration for various works. Like if we want to study, this will improve our concentration. We will be happy to see the growth of the plant inside our houses. But we have to identify the places in our home where we can keep this indoor plant. Like we can identify where our windows are, where air is properly coming, which plant require more light, which plant require less light. According to that, we can place our plants in the home, but they have to be taken care of. We cannot leave them as such. We have to check the soil, whether it is moist or it is dry, leaves are browning or not, or any other changes occurring inside the plant, any insect or pest is attacking the plant. If insect and pest is attacking the plant inside our homes, then we can use the neem solution. We can make the neem solution at home. We can take the neem leaves. We can boil into water. We can cool it. Then we can add it to our plant. So pests, mites will be controlled. Water we have to take care of. Sunlight, some plant they require sunlight. So that we also have to take care of. Thank you for watching my video. If you like the video, please subscribe it and share it. Thank you so much.